'Twould seem the magics have returned us. How polite.
Ah, we were bound to run into a living statue eventually. And now we can open the door.
Who would disturb a hero's deserved slumber? A tomb, just as I thought. Befitting a hero.
She is Vis. Could that be the Archmage Tiuna? A legendary hero of Ronka, as you surmised. The tales tell of how she smote entire armies with a single incantation. So potent was her spellcraft, though she ever fought in the name of peace.
I thought them no more than tales. To think she really existed.
Well, I for one always believed.
By the light of fallen stars, great power awakens.
Tiuna was not only a master of spellcraft. It is said she could see truths long lost and hear the voices of men's hearts.
Naught less than the echo. In which case, none of this is mere coincidence. A shower of stars setting the sky aflame. And in both this world and the Source, we find individuals within whom a mysterious power awakened at the sight. We can never unpick the why of it. Now, however, I believe we might. Does the scene depicted here not resemble the one we saw when we first ventured into the Katana Ravel? Moreover, does it not recall that which Emmet Selk invited us to witness in Amarot? The final days. If, as the Exarch's research suggests, soul and mind share a fragile yet profound bond, might it not be possible for an event to leave such a deep imprint upon the soul that it could be perceived eons later, given a suitable trigger? The Echo defies explanation by conventional etherological theory, or shall we say modern etherological theory. But if it is a power that once belonged to the ancients, to souls yet undivided, it would seem I have entered the realm of pure speculation, and I call myself a scholar. I shall refrain from making any further wild claims until such time as I have evidence. Still, I cannot choose but be reminded of our experience in Amarot. Thank you. remember us.
History is learned, not lived. We have always protected the tales of Ronka. But we are mindful of what our mothers taught us. We see the past through our own eyes and speak of it with our own words. Thus do we come to understand it in our own way. But this is not the same as remembering.
Your mothers were wise. Though we witnessed the final days, our impressions cannot fail to be colored by our own experiences and expectations. Those who lived through it would have perceived the event quite differently. We must bear in mind that it is no simple matter to keep the truth alive, or it will die with Emmett Selk and his kin. But we have disturbed Hugh not long enough. Fanau will serve similarly well as a venue for our contemplations.
Thank you. If you are hoping to vent your frustrations on our Aether friend here, I can only apologize.
Few as they are now, it took us no time at all to track it down.
That suits our purpose perfectly. Now we need only wait for Ardbert to arrive.
Weren't you two meant to be attending to the empty?
We were, and are. But we can hardly ignore the rest of the world. So we thought we might see how things were coming along. From what we can gather, the answer is strangely.
Right now, we think we can do more good here.
It is heartening to have all present.
Indeed. We will be glad of the additional hands should matters escalate.
Our quarry has come.
It seems I've lost this particular race. Well, though I suppose it's only fair. When we first met, it was I who outpaced you. Ravana, was it? But where are my manners? I wouldn't be here were it not for you, and I have yet to say a word of thanks. Arm giving you trouble? You should have it examined.
Very well. Let us forego this pretense. After all, it was never you that I needed to deceive. Yes, it is I, Elitibus. Through your time in Emmet Selk's imitation of our home, I dare say you have gained a better understanding of my role since last we met. Not that it matters.
We understand your role, Emissary, but not your goal. What is it that you seek to achieve?
I seek... of course. If it helps you to think of me as but another Asian, no different in nature or purpose from the rest, you are welcome to do so.
Once, I would have said your goal was destruction alone. Now I understand that you fight for something you love, just as we do. Yet though we seem doomed to clash, I bid you consider Emmet Selk's final words. Remember that we once lived, he said. Had he not seen some glimmer of hope in our kind, I do not believe he would have spoken thus.
None better understood your plight than he. His words must surely be worthy of your consideration.
Emmet Selk. How very unlike you to err so gravely. That one should stray at the end of so onerous a path is understandable. But I had thought you above such weakness. Mayhap you thought the same. Would that I had been present to offer correction. But I shall do so now, as is my duty, and return all to its proper course. As for you, look at yourselves. Look at your history. Look back 100 short years to how your greatest warriors were undone. And now, at but a word from me, you raise your hands in answer like the puppets you are. Naught has changed. You fail, and you fail, and you learn nothing. Allow that which is most important to slip through your fumbling fingers like so many grains of sand, again and again and again, and you would remember us. You do forget yourselves. There is no common ground to be found between you and I, nor do I require any. I have my duty.
Wait!
Well, we have confirmed the identity of our foe, at least. And 'tis safe to say his objective is the rejoining.
But we still have no idea how playing the part of a warrior of light will further his cause, nor why he would spur others to do the same.
Another visit to the Tempest may shed some light upon these mysteries. Whether we are to exchange words or blows with Elidibus at our next meeting, the fact remains, we know too little. Ere our paths cross again, I would learn more of the world that once was, and of Elidibus himself. In this, we would be best served going directly to his home, much as Emmett Selk came to ours.
Though I see the wisdom in thy suggestion, the Amarot we visited is but a phantom born of Emmett Selk's memory. I fear it will teach us little that we do not already know.
I quite agree. Yet the ruins of the actual city remain unexplored. Given the vastness of the Tempest, I should not be surprised were there more such structures like to those in which the Ondo reside. A woman after my own heart.
Assuming we are all in agreement, then I suggest we first pay a visit to the Ondo. If anyone can tell us where more ruins are to be found, it is them.
Thank you. Oh,
This structure must have served an important function. And here are yet more crystals.
I too noted the crystal repository on the way. The Benthos seem to employ them in their spellcasting.
In such vessels did the ancients preserve concepts, ideal forms to be drawn upon in the act of creation. That so great an abundance should reside here lendeth credence to Ishtola's conclusion. This facility held great significance.
It was they who first summoned Hydaelyn.
Their discussion did seem to imply as much, yes. I cannot say I have ever heard of this Venar before.
For a certainty, Emmet Selk never uttered the name, speak though he did of the schism which Zodiac's advent wrought upon mankind. Some were of the viewpoint that his power must needs be restrained. And to that end, they call forth she who would serve as his shackles. We now know that it was this Venar to whom they looked for leadership.
And that this place, in all likelihood, served as their headquarters. The presence of such intimate records attests to that. I would hear what else they have to tell us. All of it. Did anyone see the source of the image? The device there? Then let us see what other secrets it holds. What? Forgive me, but did that not strongly imply that Elidibus sacrificed himself to become Zodiac's heart? Then who or what are we dealing with?
Dare I ask what's going on?
Ah, excellent timing. For me, in any case. We have a problem. The vast majority of those gathered here are presently in the employ of the guard or else one of the facets, and no longer wish to be so. In principle, all are free to change vocation at any time. But a city does require a certain number of people in these positions. As you may have surmised, we have the Warrior of Light to thank for this. It's you! You understand, don't you? Someone's going to have to look after this place once you're gone. We just want to be ready to do our bit when the time comes.
And not only here, but everywhere. Which is why we've got to get out there and lend a hand to those in need. That's what you did, isn't it? Even if it was just little things at the start. You helped people. And we're trying to do the same. We may have our sky back, but there's no shortage of people who still need help. If we follow in your footsteps, then I choose to believe we too can be heroes one day. Even warriors of light.
What are we to say to that? We can hardly tell them they are mistaken. They seek but to do good, as you have.
But no more can we stand idly by and suffer a paragon's scheme to proceed unchallenged.
What's happening to the sky?
Wicked White. Oh no.
The 12.
A star shower.
I hear a voice.
You and all. Why does it feel like it's inside my head?
Here? Feel? Think? I hear it.
Me too.
Did I not tell you, my friends? You are warriors of light! You're back! What you hear is the voice of light itself, and it has blessed you with its power. Welcome to the fold!
I'm a warrior of light.
I've been chosen?
Can it be?
Me, a hero. Wait! The falling stars, were they your doing? And why do you need warriors of light?
What, am I to reveal my plans simply because you asked? Nay, I think not. Though the stars, I acknowledge mine. A convenient illusion, apt to awaken what little is left of the power that once resided in your sundered souls. That which you and yours call the Echo. And an echo it is, of a symphony. But a fraction of what men in their completeness once possessed. Even those among you who tower over others in the gift have only the faintest trace of it. But though sundered and forgotten through death and mocking rebirth, it has persisted. A whisper of our past. Burned into your very ether, along with the sight of our end. Through the rekindling of memory, I have awoken the ability, just as Heidlin is wont to do when she has need of new minions.
The Echo has ever been thought a gift from Heidlin, a boon granted solely to her chosen. Yet thou wouldst claim she merely awakeneth the power that men should hearken unto. Her voice. Given the perceived simultaneity of her call and the awakening of her chosen's capacity to hear it, it is only natural that we thus attributed the source of the gift. Yet if, in truth, the Echo is a prerequisite for hearing her voice, one might surmise that her call never ceaseth, such that all who awaken to their innate gift might receive of the blessing of light at the selfsame instant. In sooth, we bore witness to this but moments ago. At the sight of the star shower, full many in the crowd did speak of hearing a voice in their minds, did they not?
Just so. And whenever Heidlin has need of new servants, she is quick to pluck comets from the heavens or create illusions of the same.
Why, then, didst thou conjure this vision, full knowing that thine age-old foe would thus claim those awakened to the gift?
Foe? You must be mistaken. As you see, I am a warrior of light. And together with my comrades in arms, I shall save the world. Just like you.
Thank you. foiled again. If I cannot imbue the infernal thing with my power via magical means, we may need to devise a way to infuse the vessel with my blood after all.
Art thou unwell?
Oh, perhaps a brief respite? It wouldn't do to overtax yourself.
I'm fine. And given to stubbornness, I'm afraid. Especially when I have a stake in the outcome.
A recurring dream. They do so fascinate me. Might I trouble you for the details?
I have always dreamed of it. Fire falling from the heavens, and the city, nay, the whole world ablaze.
Indeed. Could Emmett Selk have found a way? Precious few possess memories of the final days.
The final days?
Why, yes. Admittedly, my knowledge is mostly second-hand, but if you are interested, I will gladly tell you the tale. The tale of the world's end.